WBS membership and everything, so I feel it's better to be introduced about her institute and what kind of data and what are the long series data, how we can be collaborate with Core Data and Disclu World Data Centers, and what are the kind of the things which we can initiate at our institute to preserve and to archive all the long series geomagnetic data, and how important it is for the space weather and upper atmospheric research, the kind of things which we have that. So it's my colleagues, Mahendra and Rakesh, Mr. Shami is here, and Director Ramesh is his main director of this project. So I'll briefly tell about the history of the geomagnetism in India. So first, it's our IAG is a premier research institute which can have the basic and applied geosciences and geomagnetism. And it started with the Kolaba Observatory in 1841 actually, with the eye observations and everything. So later, it is because of the trams and other electricity noise in the Bombay, we moved to Alibaug, which is a primary magnetic observatory in almost 1906. And some of the time we did the parallel measurements at both stations, and then later Kolaba is closed and we can make it as Alibaug, which is almost 110 years long series of geomagnetic measurements there. And then Kolaba is almost like 1845 to 1906, we have all the observations and everything. So having this huge, vast geomagnetic data series, so we was trying to have that preservation and conservation of all the magnetograms and how to do the data and the kind of the research initiated in magnetic observatories and what are the developments which the institute has taken to take care of all these things. I'll just briefly explain to you. So the World Data Center Geomagnetism, which is actually started in first data center as in 1971, which is called is WDC2, and India and Japan is our WDT is mainly supported by WDC Kyoto, by Japan University, my colleagues Ihori-san and Rose-san. So we have collaboration project with them. And the latter it is got re-recognized as WDC Geomagnetism Mumbai in 1991. So there are some geomagnetic observatories in India, which was, as I was saying, this is the Navi Mumbai headquarters and Alibaug Observatory. The Kolaba was in Mumbai actually. So if we move to Alibaug now. So this is 100 years old, this is the whole data center. And later all the geomagnetic observatories are successfully started, knowing the importance of the latitudes and the importance of the scientific interest actually. And India, which is very fortunate to have the deep equator, which is passing very close to the equator. So we have one station right away there as a Tirunelveli, and then followed by the all latitudinal one. When you look into the upper atmospheric research, there's a SQ focus points, we call it as, and there is a atmospheric current vertical system. So there we can have the focus point here in Gulmarg. So that was the scientific interest to establish all these magnetic observatories by Indian Institute of Geomagnetism. And this is the little seismological affected faulty area. So we have two more observatories in northeast region. And this is the meridian. And this chain of the stations is connected with the Russian network of geomagnetic observatories. So a lot of publication, almost like I can say some hundreds of publications have come out of using this data. And of course, I'm in charge of these magnetic observatories. We preserve the long series of the data, so we use all the modern technologies, the magnetograms, the processing, the photographic things, so to make the data available to the world for scientific session. And many of the people have used this kind of stations' data for their space weather research and upper atmospheric research, hydrospheric research as well. So this is mainly organization chart is consists of like that. This is the Government of India, which is supported by Department of Science and Technology, which is very near to our JNU now here. And we have the Research Advisory Committee and the Governing Council, and then Funding Finance Committee as well, and all be led by the director, who is Dr. Professor Ramesh. And we have three scientific divisions in our institute. This is Upper Atmospheric Research and the Solid Earth. And this is ODA, that is Observatory and Data Analysis, who look after the magnetic observatories here. And this is a part of that is WDC Geomagnetism. And we have the WDC Finance and Manpower, which is director, the professor in charge, and two staff members are working. So the other divisions and the ODA division, what more the part of that is being into that. So I can say that seeing the earlier presentations, so we're mostly driven by the data-based research and publications and then citations. So we don't much use the data as publication of the data in the journals, because the financial committee with the limited funding facilities, so it is very difficult for us to publish only the data. We all the scientists were little more encouraged to do the publications than the radar data-based journal publications and everything, because as we know, it's mainly the publication matters kind of thing, so they look into that. But a lot of the data is available in our website. People can use it and can publish as well also. But mainly the core data, journals, how we have to publish our data and the recent events, any campaign events. So that can be very interested to know from me, and I can take anybody suggestions to implement that as well. And then it is this WDC is currently located in Colaba Magnetic Observatory, where we have the long heritage structure building, and is typical by IAG. And this is all the stations data ranging from deep equator to SQ focus of the data is coming to our headquarters. And so that this WDC is having not only from Indian station and other stations data as well. So it's providing the huge magnetic data support for that. And now recently, actually April 2014, the support of WDS members, so we are becoming the members of WDS system since April 2014. So this is a very well equipped data preservation set, which contains the 1800 centuries long magnetograms, which we have the preservation with the professional techniques which have been used and preserved here. And this is our NAS systems and all the servers which we host the WDS Mumbai website, and also all the data, which is the old data, is not yet completely ready. It's still process is going on to imaging the micrograms and then digitization and then preservation of all those things. It is a long project. We have initiated a few years back only. And again, it's support is very much needed for the financial support from the agencies actually. So mainly activities of the Mumbai, it is a center mainly for the data depository, geomagnetic data sets, and for the scientific community interest. And it's also responsible for the maintaining the data catalog. So what are the data which is available, hourly data, and since 1970s, we have only 1 hour interval data, which was used by the using the magnetograms and all those things. The latter, we started with the digital magnetometers and started the 1 minute and 1 second interval data as well. Slowly developed into the 12 magnetic observatories now. So this kind of major steps, yeah, we'll be taking care of all the data and formats of the IACA 20 and 2002. So, and this is an intermagnet, which is the standardization of the data quality. And I'm happy to say that two stations are almost get the credibility of the intermagnet station. So this is our infrastructure. This is our World Data Center record room. And all the world magnetograms we recorded here, and the this imaging sector and kind of a servers and everything. So the present data is like ASCII data, hourly geomagnetic indices. We calculate the indices also, and some of the very microfilm and microfinches also we are doing into that. So this is all related to the WDC of Mumbai, and the data volumes we publish electronically, and earlier we used to have the hard copies of that. And now maintaining the very updated World Data Center, Geomagnetism Mumbai, which means we have the observatory information and registration and access to the hourly, all the metadata information we try to give in as much as possible. And the old magnetograms are not yet ready, so we can even open them as for the community to do any research kind of work also. And this is upgraded with the web portal with the more online data services. See, all the magnetic observatory data can be checked using this website, and online data can also be checked using station by station in this one. So the preservation historic data, we had started with the Alibag and 1890 to 1924. So some of the things we could finish, and but still lot of things was left. So it is ongoing process data. You can reach to the any questions to WDCIAGS email. And this is the server setup for our thing, the Colaba database and NAS backup. And to preserve this data is very important. So replication of the data set between two servers. So headquarters and the Colaba, we have all the data will be mutually saved and secured into the servers and everything. So this is the website is hosted for the Windows 2003, and it will be upgraded with the time to time also. So front-end and all the latest technologies will be used on that. So this is the links to the headquarters is like MPPS and BSNL links here. These are the some observatories which are all connected to the WDC here and also headquarters. This is the processing. This is the completely chart of our system here. And then key targets to develop the digitization software, which will be the digitized world micrograms. So we started actually and doing that also. And manpower and support is very much needed again. To make available these old valuable geomatic data sets and international community for research, because the, I would like to mention the 1859 data, one is the Carrington event, which is well published, geomatic storm was published by our group in with Surutani, Lakina and Alex, which was very well cited paper. It is a very huge geomagnetic storm and how it has given impact into the problems into the northern and other places, the communication system, AUs and all those stuff. So any kind of a prediction of those storms in the future, but this this whole data set is very useful to do that kind of work. So it will be open to the community too soon, and collaborate with other WDS members and to implement new technology and fast data handling to standards to implement the data storage facilities of the center. So this is the main activities there. Thank you very much.